Okay.
Thought I would do a little quick overview of the PS Vita TV. So, here we go. Alright, so, pretty much what you have is the basic PS Vita layout. So you can have all of your stuff up here, your content, your system menus, nothing's unfamiliar. So, the one thing that is new is the PlayStation Now feature. So we'll just take a look at that. Hopefully this loads. PSN has been acting up like the last 3 days selectively. So, I mean, it hasn't really messed up on the Vita, but people have been complaining a lot about it messing up on the PS4, PS3. So pretty much what this is supposed to be, is the Netflix of game streaming. So, it's got some decent selection of games. Like, you can go into the filter and filter by what type of content you actually want. You can filter by price. But here's what's deceptive. All those $2 through $4.99, you're like, oh, sweet, I can get games for reasonable prices. No, not actually. Watch this. You go to Playtime. Let's go to full PS3 games, right? It's alright, cool. Full PS3 game. Sly Cooper. Why you would need this when Sly Cooper came out on the Vita is beyond me. But you got it. So you go and you're like, the hell, $1.99? That's a great deal. But if you notice, that is renting the game for 4 hours. 4 hours for $2 is the worst rental service ever. 7 days is $6, 30 days is $8, and 90 days is $14. And while I admit renting something for 30 days for only, you know, what, $8 isn't bad, or renting it for 90 days for $14, you're probably going to get absolutely all the play out of it that you want. You can go buy a used copy of Sly Cooper for probably $14 anyways, and actually own it indefinitely. So, yeah, long way to come on this rental service. Pretty freaking awful. But, I mean, it is cool that you can stream games. What'll be really interesting is if you can stream PS4 games. Kind of looking into that. Don't really want to buy a PS4 right now. Maybe some of the American exclusive games. This will keep me from having to buy it. I'm still holding out on wanting a PS4 because Falcom seems to be still supporting the Vita, so. Alright, so all the games that you see up here are the games that are compatible on the TV. So, quite a few games. Now, these are PSP games, and that's a PS1 game down there. These, however, are games not supported. So, I mean, just quite a bit of not supported stuff. I mean, I have two folders not supported. And some of this stuff makes no sense. Metal Gear Solid? Worked on a PS2. Here's the controller you're playing with. PS3 controller should be 100% compatible. Same with Virtual Tennis 4 also has a console release. No point in that. Ninja Gaiden Sigma Plus definitely has a console release and is on the compatibility list, and it still doesn't even work. Doesn't have an update, nothing. Resistance, that could work. Shinobi Do, that could work. You go into here. Ridge Racer has absolutely no touchscreen features except for the menu. Absolutely pathetic that doesn't work. Mortal Kombat doesn't work. Phantasy Star Online 2, that's an import. Totally works with a PC, doesn't work. I swear, the only reason they're not making that work is because they want you to play the PC one instead. There's absolutely no games in here that are so touch-intensive that they couldn't be supported. Soul Sacrifice has some stuff, but all this is basic D-pad. Celceta, they say it may work. I mean, every version besides the English one does, so it kind of sucks, but Exceed's working on that. So, I guess we'll just look at some games because people are saying the picture quality is pretty terrible. Granted, this is a 24-inch TV. Obviously, everything's going to probably look pretty good on this, so it's not the best representation of how bad or pixelated stuff looks. Sonic looks really good. Toukenden looks really good. We'll go with some, can't ever pronounce this, Sharon Kura. Suck at reading stuff out loud. I don't know why. But let's see what we got here. That's Ninja Gaiden. That supposedly works. Doesn't. Does not work at all. Also wanted to say that this is a really awesome limited edition. So, comes with a foil embossed box. I kind of like cheat on my special edition to just cut the top plastic off and keep it tight enough so I can keep the shrink wrap around it. I don't want it to get any scuffing or anything like that, but Exceed always outdoes themselves. They're really pretty much the top tier publisher for the Vita and pretty much the reason why you own one. Yeah, I probably should have had this game started up beforehand. Or chose a game that got into the gameplay a little bit quicker, but had a lot of fun with this game. I was not gonna buy it at all. Thought it was a fan service game, which it is, but the gameplay is actually solid too. I mean, I'm pretty damn close up on the TV, and the picture looks good. There's no noticeable grain or anything like that. I mean, I think it's gonna come down to a lot how your TV filters stuff. But video quality, pretty good. I mean, everything to me looked as crisp and as clear as I would expect from a 360 or PS3. Now, I was playing this game, and I will let you know some things that aren't next gen or current gen console, like shadows and some texture work. I mean, the shadows look pretty pixelated when you get in a still shot of this, but I mean, from this distance, like right here, you can't tell. But when you get into a winning close-up pose, shadows look pretty bad. I mean, you can tell the character models look fairly decent, good resolution on them. Ooh. It's a weird error that comes up in this game on the PSTV. No microphone. I don't know what the hell I would need a microphone for in the changing room of this game. I don't know if that's an issue y'all got going on Exceed, but yeah, it's weird. So, I mean, I guess I could show you a mission also. Oh man, no, we don't want to do her. We want to change characters because I'm nowhere with her. You know, I thought when the Vita was going to be a cartridge system, that meant there was going to be no loading. But apparently, I think the PS Vita memory cards are based off of an old standard SD card standard, because loading is really crap. It's not like in a Class 10 or anything like that. Oh, which one of these stages is really pretty? Ugh. can't remember. I think it's this one that I keep sucking on. So yeah, everything's smooth, fast, fluid. Don't notice any button delay or lag. Okay, but you get to see it. Everything's fine, so hit back up the menu. And show off some other things. So, go to a PS1 game. You can tell right here from this screen that it's in a 4:3 aspect ratio because the PlayStation logo didn't look stretched. So yeah, biggest gripe. I know people don't seem to care, but everything is in 4:3, so you go to your PlayStation menu, and on a Vita, under other settings, you would normally have binary filtering to smooth the picture out, and you would have a 16:9 or some sort of stretch ratio. You only have disc load speed here. Really bugs me. Don't like borders on TV, especially on an OLED where you can get burn-in or plasma. My two preferred types, don't like that, think it's pointless. I mean, the picture output looks okay. I mean, it's significantly worse than the actual Vita, though. But yeah, PlayStation works. Yay, every single digital download PlayStation game works. Just, this is how it's gonna look. Pretty much the equivalent of how it looks on a PSP, not a PS Vita. It looks pretty bad. Alright, so let's check out some PSP games instead. Legend of Heroes, totally freaking awesome game that I never played until this year. Downloaded it, wasn't interested the first time, felt way too slow for me, and then I played it, and it's one of my favorites actually now. Okay, so again, pretty bad picture. Has no binary filtering, and I think binary filtering is freaking outdated as hell anyways, seeing how this is emulated. This should be internally upscaling the resolutions to 2x to smooth out everything, and then filtering it. Because when you internal up the resolutions on this, this almost looks as good as the the PC version using like PPSSPP, the emulator on PC. So, I mean, it's all functional, it plays fine. I mean, it's just, there's no freaking options. So, again, you go to settings. That's it. Just control settings. Like, what the hell happened to all my options? Like, it doesn't make any sense. This is Vita-based hardware. They had to actively go back and remove crap for some reason or another. And lastly, but not least, you go to the PlayStation Store, and guess what you are not going to find? Netflix or Hulu. How it's called the PlayStation TV without Netflix or Hulu is so beyond me. I think this is everyone's biggest, absolute biggest complaint about the system. check this one out. While I was complaining about Ninja Gaiden earlier, I thought this was great to point out. Ninja Gaiden Sigma 2 Plus. You can go ahead and download that if you want to spend $40 on a game that doesn't even run on the TV. It's on the shop. It says it does. For some reason, whatever's going on, like the US patch server isn't connecting to the patch that it needs. The game is not compatible. Sigma 1, the older game, is compatible. It makes no sense. Surprisingly, another odd thing is all of Tecmo Koei games look top-notch, some of the best on the Vita, when playing on the Vita. On the TV, however, they're some of the more washed-out, worse-looking games, actually. They don't look good at all. Which I thought was really, really weird. Oh, excuse me. I need to go to the front page to go to apps. Nope. Apps. Behold. This is it. Is this not like the crappiest list of apps ever? Crunchyroll, it's cool. It fits into the niche that the PS Vita is, mostly Japanese games. But that's it. All your classics play. I mean, it's just really, really weird that they did that. But let's show off another game that looks really pretty. I mean, the games that play perfect, they look good. There's still a lot of games. I mean, I'm pretty happy. All your imports that are TV compatible are still TV compatible on this. You can only sign in with North American accounts, unfortunately. Still one account. Stupid and unfortunate also. But yeah, this is how it is. Sonic All-Star looks really good. Let's see if I have that over here. One thing that amazed me, I thought the PS TV, Vita TV would be about the size of PSP, or excuse me, a Vita, but it is tiny. It is smaller than a cell phone. It's definitely smaller than an iPhone 5. It's about the same size as an iPhone 4. I mean, the case for Tokenden is actually bigger than the system itself. So, this is the first time I played All-Star Racing was a couple days ago, and I've owned it forever. This game looks fantastic. This looks, in my opinion, as good as probably the console versions of the game. Like, the Vita is really an underrated system. It's got plenty of good games, and in my opinion, I think that it's my go-to system for this generation. I sold my Xbox One, and I'm probably going to buy one again, but I'm tempted to just buy more import Vita games and a 64GB memory card, because there's so many good games, and if you mostly prefer Japanese games, portable gaming's where it's at, but if you prefer games on your TV, the PSTV is like your last choice. But I mean, everything plays good, everything looks good, so I mean, that's pretty much it. For $100, I mean, it's a pretty decent system, and I get why a lot of people are mad. There's just like stuff that should work that doesn't, but if you have a good library of games, you're still going to be able to play them on your TV, and you're still going to get enjoyment out of them. So I mean, it's not like the system's useless. It's just, yeah, could it have been freaking awesome? Absolutely. But right now, if you've got games that you want to play on a TV, go for it. I know Tom and Exceed thinks that the PSV has a better picture output than this, but I'm going to let you know if you're an average person like me with normal eyes, I consider myself a videophile. Like, I like good picture quality. The PSP sucks. I don't know what he's talking about. Like, this looks a bajillion times better, even on your PSP games. At least it's corner to corner, and at least it's less grainy. I mean, you're not going with composite cables if you're on a 3000 model anymore. You're getting a lot better picture, so it's really up to you. But for $100, why not?